Video editing is an involving process, which usually takes a lot of time and effort, and having a slow GPU can make the experience really frustrating. Now, if you're confused about which graphics card to get for your video editing rig, whether AMD or Nvidia, gaming benchmarks don't really translate well into video editing performance. So which one do you go for, AMD or Nvidia, and which one makes much more sense for video editing? Let's answer it. So we're mainly going to look at the performance of three softwares, DaVinci Resolve, Blender, and Premiere Pro. Now I can't possibly compare all the GPUs out there, so I'll mainly be focusing on two mid-range GPUs, that's the RTX 3060 from Nvidia and the RTX 6600 from AMD. Both are priced pretty close, at least in today's market. Now the difference in performance between these two cards are also maintained when you go up in the price brackets. So these cards should be pretty suitable for this comparison, as they're also quite popular in the market at the moment. So let's talk about the specifications of both of these cards. The RTX 6600 has 1792 stream processors with 64 ROPs. The RTX 3060 on the other hand has around 3584 CUDA cores with 48 ROPs. So the RTX 3060 has almost double the amount of cores compared to the 6600, which will definitely come in handy while video editing. The RTX 6600's base clock speeds are 1626 MHz and boosts up to 2490 MHz, while the RTX 3060 has a base clock speed of 1320 MHz and boosts up to 1778 MHz. So the 6600 is quite a bit faster, at least in the clock speeds, as compared to the 3060. Both have GDDR6 VRAM, the RX 6600 has a 128-bit memory bus at 224 GB/s, while the RTX 3060 has a 192-bit memory bus at 360 GB/s. So both are pretty comparable in terms of specifications, and in fact the RX 6600 beats the 3060 in terms of gaming, which doesn't really matter all that much because we're talking about video editing performance here. And now, you might have noticed that I didn't really talk about the VRAM because it's very obvious. The more VRAM you have, the better it is for video editing. Simple. So let's talk about the benchmarks for DaVinci Resolve. So the graphics cards were paired with Ryzen 5 5600G and 16 GB of DDR4 RAM at 2600 MHz. The RTX 3060 gets a score of 1170 in DaVinci Resolve benchmark, while on the other hand, the RX 6600 scored 1083. So not that big of a difference, but the RTX 3060 stays ahead nonetheless. This trend also continues when you jump higher into the 3060 Ti and the 6600 XT. So Nvidia cards do perform better than AMD cards in DaVinci Resolve. Now for a lot of people, including myself, the amount of time it takes to render a clip doesn't really matter all that much if the performance is the same during the editing session, that is real-time rendering. And both of these cards are able to play 4K footage with sharpening applied without any lags, and scrubbing through footage was also not a problem for either of them. So if you're coming from a GT 710 or even an integrated GPU, then either of these cards will be more than enough for you and will be a massive improvement. What we saw with DaVinci Resolve also reflects in Premiere Pro. The RTX 3060 seems to be performing better than the RTX 6600 again, where the 3060 scores 702 and the 6600 scores 496. However, when you go up the price comparing the 3060 Ti and the 6600 XT, the gap in performance actually diminishes, where the 3060 scores 823 while the 6600 scores 684. Now upon testing the render speeds of a 4K 25fps clip with sharpening and glow applied, the RTX 3060 finished the rendering in 2 minutes 13 seconds, while it took 2 minutes 49 seconds for the RX 6600 to render the clip. So not that big of a difference. Now bear in mind that Premiere Pro isn't really a very good software for benchmarking all these, because Premiere Pro heavily relies on CPU instead of the GPU. So while Nvidia cards do perform better than AMD cards in Premiere Pro, but I think you'll be fine with either one of them. So let's move on to Blender. Alright, now this is where the difference between both of these cards are massive and shows why most Blender artists prefer Nvidia over their AMD counterparts. In the benchmark, the RTX 3060 absolutely obliterates the RX 6600, where the RTX 3060 scores 2445 while the 6600 only scored about 873. Yep, the difference is massive. And this trend even continues when we compare the 3060 Ti and the 6600 XT. The 3060 Ti scores around 3067, while the 6600 only scored about 1003. So the Nvidia cards are almost 3 times faster than the AMD cards in 3D rendering in Blender. Now we have to keep in mind that AMD cards are getting better and better in Blender with the implementation of HIP, which is specifically made for AMD cards, just like optics is for Nvidia cards. So this huge difference in performance might shrink in future with newer and better versions of HIP. So after comparing both of these cards in all the three softwares, it's quite clear that Nvidia cards perform better overall than AMD cards. Now if you also consider other 3D programs like Cinema 4D or even Mocha Pro or even After Effects, Nvidia cards outshine AMD cards even further. Also, if you have an Nvidia GPU, then most likely you will have the NVENC engine, which gives you much better streaming performance and much faster video encoding. Now, I'm not in favor of Nvidia or anything. In fact, it's the complete opposite. I really want AMD to do better than Nvidia in terms of video editing because their cards are much cheaper, their driver support is much better these days, and even in Linux, their driver support is much, much better than Nvidia. But if I have to choose between Nvidia and AMD for video editing in 2023, it has to be Nvidia. So I hope you found this video helpful in some way, and if you have any kind of suggestions, do leave them down in the comment section below. Thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.